QuadJacks.com. My name is Toby, and I'm sitting here with the ultimate grinder, Randy Liu, nanonoko. Nanonoko, welcome. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Right now I'm playing the 1K No Limit. 60 players left, so trying to final table one of these.
Okay. How is that going? Actually, we just spoke before the interview. You said you only play No Limit events. Now it's pretty deep. How is the game flow going, like, so deep? Does it help you that you have so much experience playing, like, cash games online? How is that, or is that something right now which doesn't help you as much?
I would say the cash game stuff doesn't really help as much right now, because it's not playing like a cash game at all. We're all playing like 30 big blinds or so. So some practicing tournament like online is going to help a lot more in these situations. Regardless, I feel fine. I think some of the guys there are kind of nervous a little bit, so they're going to play very straightforward. So I think I have a pretty good read on everyone. I think I'm going to make some good decisions.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know, you play a lot online and you have lost a lot of big pots, you have won a lot of big pots, but people in general say live poker is more tilting. It's harder to leave a table in a live poker tournament than losing a big pot online. Would you say that's true, or what's harder for you?
For me, I don't get tilted live for some reason. Maybe it's because you're just around other people. I don't know. I don't play live cash. Maybe that's why. Maybe live cash. Say you lose a big pot, and usually you're playing a little bit bigger stakes than online, I'd imagine. You know, you're playing nine-handed. You're not going to get the opportunity to win your chips back anytime soon. So I can understand why maybe people get tilted. But for me, it doesn't bother me. In a tournament, you know, when you lose your chips, you can't rebuy and go tilt those off. If you lose your chips, you go home. And then you get a rest up, which is nice. And then you get to play the next day. So for me, it's not tilting at all.
Mm-hmm. For someone who plays so many hours, so many tables of cash game, when you're coming home to your hotel room here in Vegas, be honest, how much do you miss getting back into the online grind?
I miss playing online poker, especially like, say I lose one of these tournaments, you know. I think I do well online, you know. It's kind of like I can just play a day and kind of make my buy-in back at least, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's unfortunate I don't get to play, but for me, I've like got more balance in my life. So it doesn't bother me as much as before. Maybe in the beginning it was a lot harder. But now it's kind of like no, I've got this time of the month I go play online poker. This time up, I'm just playing tournaments. Mm-hmm. And so I've already got that mindset in my head that if I lose these tournaments, it's okay. I've already accepted it. The worst case scenario is that I lose X amount. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So
it doesn't bother me.
You're talking about balance your life, and you said like you basically get away from online poker to come here to Vegas. I guess it's also for the EV because you think you're favoring most of these fields. But is it fair to say that like playing live tournaments for you is a kind of relaxation, is kind of a vacation?
I would say that's exactly true. Whenever I go to say the World Series or I go to EPTs or whatnot, I really only play like the big, like I would only play the main event when I go to those events. I don't really play the side ones. And then if I lose those tournaments, usually I'm in a destination I've never been. I'll go travel around. It's real nice. It's really kind of like you said, it's relaxing. Mm. Here, it's kind of nice. It's a nice change up. It's not like constantly playing a lot of hands in 1 minute. Now I'm just taking my time on my decisions. Mm-hmm. A little slower. I play a little slower live, but you know, I feel good about it. It's nice. If I lose, I'll go hang out with someone and eat some food, whatever. Yeah.
Not the worst thing in the world.
No.
What would you say about your ROI in live tournaments so far? How well have you been done over the last few years?
I don't know my exact ROI, but I've been doing pretty good. I'm probably up at least $500,000 net in live tournaments lifetime because I won the Macau tournament. And I've got like some final tables, but like eighth place or like some deep finishes. But yeah, it's not bad. I'll take it.
Are you paying this out of your own pocket or are you getting backed?
No, I don't. I always take all my action. So that's why you won't see me playing like a lot of the big high roller events like in Macau. I like to take all my action and that's just too much for me. Mm-hmm. So I just play all these events myself.
Okay. Nanonoko, one last word about you. Usually you're a mid-stakes grinder, right? 3, 6, 5, 10, 24 tables. That's your world. That has been your world over a few years. Uh-huh. Now people have seen the poker world has I've seen that you played a lot of high-stakes poker. Sometimes you sit 100, 200, no-limit heads-up, 50, 100. You play a lot against the best guys in the world. Share with us a little bit, why are you looking for this competition? Is it really to play with the best, or do you really think like that maximizes your EV even more?
It's a bit of everything, to be honest. When I first made the jump to the higher stakes, I was kind of like, I think I can hang with these guys. So there's some good games, so my profit should go up. Another thing is that sometimes I play with these other regs, the high stakes regs, and they're all very good players. I think my game improved a lot. I don't think I'm the best no-limit 6-max player out there. I'm probably one of the better ones that can play all those tables. That's kind of my thing. So I do learn a lot playing with a lot of those high stakes guys, and even if I do lose in those situations, right, I really like gain a lot of knowledge. And now, like my off time, I can think back on some of my sessions, kind of like say, how do I improve my game, whatnot. Plus, I'm kind of a guy like that doesn't like to settle, just kind of like be happy where you're at. And in poker, if you don't stay on top of the game, you're going to get left behind, as a lot of people know. Like, if you don't play for a year or two and you come back, you're probably going to not be a winner, or you might break even at best. So that's another thing. It helps me stay on top of my game, because the game is always changing.
So would you say it's something like you play with maybe better people than you, just to improve your own game, to learn from better players, and paying therefore maybe a little bit because you're slight a dog to them?
I mean, I don't know if I'm actually a dog or not, right? But I don't think I'm. If I am a dog, it's not a huge dog. You know what I mean? And I'd say it's a bit of both. You know what I mean? But sometimes. I'll play if the game is good too, and then even if they're a little bit better or if we're the same, it's great. But really, I've seen my game kind of like evolve as I play. Sometimes I play with these regs, and I feel like I'm a better player when I play, pretty much.
All right. That's awesome to hear that, because you play for so many years and you're still improving. So I think that's an advice for everyone out there. Keep learning, keep playing. Thank you very much. It was nice talking to you.
Yeah,
Brandy
Liu,
good luck in that 1K.
Yeah, thank you very much.
QuadJacks.com.